The quintessential great Australian dream used to look a bit like this.
So you'd be able to give me a value on this?
That's my job.
That'd be good. Do you want me to show you around?
If you wouldn't mind.
Yeah. Oh, not at all. Be pleased. Because between you and me, I reckon values around here are...
Give me a home among the gum trees with lots of plum trees.
But rising property prices have forced the dream to be redefined a little. And to tell us more is social researcher Mark McCrindle. Good morning to you, Mark.
Hello.
We'll start off by getting you to tell us what is considered the average Australian.
Well, from an income perspective, the average Aussie is earning about $80,000 a year. That's full-time earnings. That's a little higher than most people might experience because it's bumped up a little by the high-income earners. But that's what you can expect. People are retiring in their early 60s still. Rent is just under $500 per week for the average person. And the average house cost in an Australian capital city is just under the $800,000 mark. So you can see the challenge is that the average house is about 10 times average annual earnings, whereas 4 decades ago, the average house was just 5 times average earnings. So the house prices are growing faster than wages.
Yeah, it really is crazy. And the great Australian dream was once that quarter acre block in the suburbs. How has that changed now? What are more and more Aussies looking for these days?
Well, people don't want to just move further away from the city near parks and bushlands. People these days want to move closer into the city. It's the cafes and the restaurants. That's what they're looking to be near, not just the bush or parks. And also people are looking to downsize a little. This next generation starting homes don't need a big garage to store all their stuff. They're wanting something a bit smaller. Minimalism, you know, it's called. And they don't need the 2 cars. They're happy to ride share or share a car, maybe get by on one, be closer to public transport. The walkable community, not just the ones where you need to drive everywhere. So these are the trends we're starting to see. And partly because of the cost of a big 4-bedroom home in the suburbs, people are wanting to downsize to something a little smaller, and that's why we're seeing the growth of units and apartments right across Australia.
Yeah, and we all know house prices are so high, so are a lot more people just opting to rent for life, in fact, these days?
Yes, a lot more renting, and you're right, renting for longer. So about 30% of Australians are renters. So we've got more renters in Australia than people who have paid off their home. So that's been quite the trend. And partly with that, people are not just renting for affordability reasons. Maybe they want to live in from a lifestyle perspective where they can't afford to buy, so they'll rent there. For others, it's just the ability to lock up and leave that place and travel and spend money not on a big mortgage, but maybe on other lifestyle pursuits. So the renters are growing because of the cost of housing.
But there's often a bit of a negative stereotype attached to renting for a long time. Are there some benefits to it as well?
Well, there are. I mean, a lot of people are getting good affordability out of renting, and they're called rentvestors. So they're renting, but they maybe bought a place. Maybe they bought a place in the outskirts of town. It's not going to work for them to live there, but they still get the asset appreciation of that. Meanwhile, they rent where they want to live, and so can get some lifestyle in that process.
And for Gen Y, that's my generation, that seems to be the focus of not being able to afford a house. So many people in that generation feel like it's just out of their reach. Are we all going to be okay, Mark?
I think so. Look, not only a Generation Y earning pretty good salaries, you know, as graduates and getting out there, but they've got more options. So they don't just have to buy the big 4-bedroom home with the swimming pool out the back. They can get the smaller units and start that way. Also, we're seeing this new generation potentially earning or getting a lot passed on from their parents. So the baby boomers are the highest net worth generation in Australia's history. And over the next 20 to 30 years, we're going to see about $2.5 trillion transferred from the older generation to the emerging generation. That might be the saving grace for a lot of younger people. They're a little bit behind the earnings just because of the rising cost of living.
All right, and quickly, will backyard cricket be okay?
It will
in
be.
The future?
Yeah, probably a local park though. Probably, unless it's on the balcony, it's probably hard to play it there. So maybe outside of the home, not just in the backyard. That's the future of the Aussie dream.
Really interesting stuff, Mark. Thanks for your time this morning.
You.